नमस्ते, आई एम सुष्मिता एंड यू आर वॉचिंग इतनी सी बात। आर यू फीलिंग लेजी टूडे? यस, वी नीड टू हैव दोज लेजी ब्रेक्स इन बिटवीन आवर बिजी शेड्यूल्स। बट इफ यू आर फीलिंग लेजी ऑफन, देन यू विल फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू कम्प्लीट योर डेली टास्क एंड वर्क। यू आर लेजी वेन यू आर अनविलिंग टू वर्क और यूज एनर्जी वेन यू नो दैट यू हैव सो मच ऑफ वर्क एंड यू हैव एनर्जी एज वेल। But you procrastinate, means you delay or postpone action. Oh, I'm not feeling well, I'll do it tomorrow. Oh, I don't understand this, I'll do it next week. You just make lame excuses. Suppose there is a water bottle on the table near you. You are feeling thirsty, but you will just not get up from there and go and get that water. You will wait for someone to enter your room and bring it along with them. Otherwise, you'll just wait to be super thirsty. At the same time, if there is an earthquake, what will you do? Will you just wait and be lazy? No, you'll get up from there and run. Why? Because there is a need. You run for your life. So when there is a need, you will never feel lazy. So if you need to be successful in life, if you need to have a good habit in your life, then you need to overcome laziness. Let us see what are the reasons for laziness, and also there are some hacks that would help to overcome laziness. I also have a bonus task for you at the end of this video, so stay tuned. Before that, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button. And if you really appreciate my work, then please hit the like button. And I always love to hear from you, so just leave a comment in the comment box. The first reason is laziness is just your habit. You have been lazy throughout your childhood days and also in your teenage, and it is continuing with you. You know, let me tell you about my childhood days. My father was very strict. He would never let us sit idle. Even though we are taking some relaxing time for ourselves, he would ask us to just go and paint something, or just go and learn a song, dance to a tune, take a walk, or do whatever you want, but just don't sit idle. Do something. That habit continues with me even today, and I cannot sit idle for more than half an hour. The second reason is technology. I remember my childhood days when we had just one TV at home, and that one TV had just two channels, Doordarshan and DD Metro. To watch those two channels, my father had given me some time limit, maybe half an hour or just 1 hour a day. But now you have more than 200 channels on TV. You can just switch on the Wi-Fi and you can go around the world through internet. I remember last week when my husband asked me to prepare paneer makhni. I just got my YouTube, my teacher, and I typed paneer makhni, and I could see so many recipes, more than hundreds and thousands of them, I don't know how much. I just scrolled through everything because I wanted to make the best paneer makhni in the whole world. I jumped from this recipe to that recipe. I didn't like the presenter's language or maybe the editing tools she used. I had so many reasons to jump from one video to another. I had so many options. After 1 hour, when my husband came back and asked me, is paneer makhni ready? I just showed him the YouTube thumbnail, which I loved the most. What did I just do? I wasted 1 hour. I may have prepared paneer makhni and many more in that 1 hour, but I became so lazy because I had so many options. So we always search through those options to get the best, and we waste our time. Just keep your gadgets away for 2 days and see how creative you can get in your work. The third reason is selective work. You love doing only some work, like you love playing video games. You never feel lazy while playing video games. Or if you are asked to go and chill out with your friends, you will not feel lazy. Why? Because you are selective at it. You like doing it. You are interested in them. But if you are asked to sit and study, you suddenly start feeling lazy. You suddenly make lame excuses. Have you thought why? Now I need to talk to you about some ways to overcome this laziness. The first hack is that you have to wake up early in the morning. That itself is impossible, but yes, you have to do that. If you really need to have that extra time in your life, you have to wake up in the morning. Do meditation, yoga, listen to affirmations to pamper yourself and also uplift your mood in the morning. Drink lots of water to stay hydrated. Write down small goals or tasks without which you won't feel like working for the whole day. And also congratulate yourself when you finish those small tiny tasks. Do something. Do not sit idle. Just go and listen to some music, take a bath, pursue your passion, dance to a tune, do something or the other. Eat food, that too, right food at right time to feel that energy inside you for the whole day. Engage yourself in good things. If you are using gadgets, then limit and restrict your time. Value your time, energy and health. Stay positive all the time. Talk positive, think positive. Be aware of yourself, most important. Self-awareness is very important. You must know why you are here, who I am, what I need. Only then you'll be able to work towards it and overcome laziness. Once you become aware of yourself, you can bring in self-discipline in your life so that you start working towards it to become super successful. Now it's time for bonus task. Do not snooze your alarm tomorrow. You have to turn it off. Wake up fresh, work towards your goals, and this is the first step to overcome laziness. How many of you would do that? Even though you do not feel a need to work, do something good every day for yourself, for your physical health and mental health. Just get up from that lazy couch and rise to success. Until we meet next time, stay happy, healthy and safe. Bye-bye.